So much, Anil Thapaji. Now our wait is over. Ani Choindolma is here. First, I'd like to introduce you, all you know, most of you know. Ani Choindolma is a Nepalese Buddhist nun from Nagi Gompa Nunnery in Nepal. She is also an exceptional singer and is also popularly known as a Buddhist rock star nun. It's a CNN.
right.
And she's performing this Friday night in Auckland. There's a live concert, and then you can purchase ticket here where you get a discounted price. And you can contact Lloyd, who's there, for the ticket. In addition to music, Ani is also renowned for her numerous humanitarian efforts, including education of young girls, like care of older people, and offering medical services for underprivileged people. And her efforts have been constantly praised and emulated. And her autobiography, Singing for Freedom, has been published in 11 languages and is listed as an international bestseller. Ani believes if given equal opportunities, nuns have the potential to make the world a better place. Recently, she has been appointed as the Goodwill Ambassador, UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador to Nepal. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ani Choindolma. And now I'd like to request our volunteers to offer khada to all our eminent speakers. And also, I'd like to welcome team, the musical team.
Yeah.
In Berkeley and San Francisco Bay Area. So without further delay, our next speaker is Ani Choi. Ani, we were asking our eminent speaker that we are in constant stress. And then Buddha has given a prescription, you know, for the prevention to deal with anxiousness and stress. And Buddhism provides the tools to transfer suffering, dukkha. In this regard, I would like you to share your thoughts on this, since you've practiced Buddhism and then you know what anxiety is, and then you have overcome the anxiety. And also, if I may, I would also like to get your perspective on why it is important to nourish not only your body and intellectual mind, but also your spiritual self. So if you could highlight on that, and that would be... And
hello. Namaste to everyone. I'm extremely sorry for being late. In a way, it is not our fault, and yes, it is our fault too. We could have left earlier, but somehow we tried to be in America and depend on the technology. And the technology was not that reliable either. So it is part of our experience being in America, so I somehow didn't worry about it. So. Well, thank you so much, Amoji, for such a wonderful introduction. At the same time, it's an honor to be sitting with wonderful people around. I feel like I'm the least academic here in a very highly respected or reputed academic institute in America. But as there is a saying in Tibetan, when a stupid speaks, the intelligent learns. So I picked it up one. I don't know if I could be able to explain in a very technical or academically what exactly what Buddha has said and how it has been articulated, or how we have to look at the suffering or how we exactly have to transform the suffering in our life. But as being a practitioner and having the most fortunate opportunity to spend some really wonderful years of my life under guidance of a great teacher in Nepal, the most eminent Tulku Ugyen Rinpoche, where one of my sisters is here, Ani Yanchi Lamala. We call her Anga Ani also. It's wonderful to see her. And spending those many years, but mainly I was raised in such a environment of so much love and so much care, and I was never, you know, made sit down and learn something very academically. What I learned is by living every day, my time with my teacher, and with his kindness and his care and his understanding towards my condition. And everything was so much in a way that I was raised in such environment to grow, to be healed. Yes, maybe I should tell you why I actually took refuge in Nagi Gompa. Nagi Gompa is one of the most beautiful places in the northern slope of Kathmandu Valley. And first of all, I decided to become a nun at the age of 10 because I was actually really suffering, I should say, traumatized by the idea of having to get married someday in the future to a man who would not respect you, who would not respect of what your desires are, or as you being in another existing human being who also has her own desires in life. Because of the society where we live in is strongly driven by very, very ignorant perception towards women, where we are calculated to be someone less capable, less intelligent, weak, you know? And a lot of the time you would hear people telling you, hey, you shouldn't do that because you're a girl. You shouldn't go there because you're a girl. You shouldn't wear that because you're a girl. You shouldn't say that because you're a girl. You should behave like a girl. You should be a good girl. The definition of a good girl means you just, whenever your father or your elderly in the family tells you to do something, then you do. Otherwise, you will not do. Or you do all the cooking, cleaning, serving. That defines you to be a good daughter and listens to your parent, whoever they want you to get married to or who they want you to get associated with to, or, you know, always saying yes, yes, yes to the mom and dad or to the family. So that defines to be a good daughter. And good wife is someone who makes the husband happy. Means does everything for the husband. Does everything for the family, who sacrifices, who thinks of her the last, who eats the last. So definition of good wife is in such